Hi, I'm Adam, and welcome to this tutorial where we're going to work with the wonderful layer masks. And I thought that a nice way to illustrate how wonderful layer masks are was to make things look like they were under water and above water. And I'll just give you some examples, like a whale. This whale originally looked like this without the layer mask, and I'll tell you what it is in just a second. This is what it looks like without the layer mask. We'll just hide the splashes, and this is what it looks like with the layer masks. And a ship, same technique. A pufferfish, which is the one we're going to work with. A dragon, and again, here it was a question of making part of the dragon appear above the water, part of it as if it was seen through the surface, and the rest of it beneath the water. And we can also, there's also like a woman swimming in the water, same technique. So let's get started. I'll try to do this. I know that time is the most valuable resource we have, so I'll try to do this as fast as I can while still presenting the techniques. So we'll just use a pufferfish here, and this is what it looks like with the layer mask, and this is without the layer mask. So a layer mask is a really clever way of letting us use black and white colors to hide and show parts of an image, instead of erasing it or putting it behind another layer. And we simply click down here like that, and now we have the layer mask here. And if we paint with black, we'll paint away that part of the image like that. So of course we could do this with the erase tool, but then it would be gone. But if we click on X and select our white color, we can paint it back on again. And this is just, I mean, you can just really have a lot of fun with this technique. So now let's try to make this beautiful pufferfish by Ray. You please see the link beneath the video. I've sent a link for it to his Instagram account. Great artist, and he allowed me to use his beautiful pufferfish in this tutorial. So what we're gonna do is, first of all, we're gonna just find the surface line here. And this is another very important thing, is that the more the opacity your brush, the more opacity it has, the more it will paint. So if we've got 100% opacity and on black, which black is the one that hides the layer, it'll just totally disappear. If it's on 10, if you can just use your numbers on the keyboard, 1, then you see it's a little bit. If it's 50, well, it's a 50%. And these numbers we're going to work a lot with. So we'll just click 0 for 100, and then we'll hide the pufferfish totally here. Like that. Maybe a bit more. There you go. Maybe actually we should move the pufferfish up a bit, like that. Yeah, something like that. And now we're just keeping the layer mask where it was. We're unlinking it, so it'll just stay where it was, and now we're linking it again. And we'll just remove here. And now comes the fun part, because this is where we can really go into details with our layer masks. So if we zoom in, create a smaller size brush and 100%, and now we're going to paint back on. We'll see that the fin, because it's closer to us, should be shown some more. See? But here, like here, be showing this. There you go. And maybe we should make the water curve a bit like that. And the tail. This one. That. That. Just X this. No, we're hiding it again. Say, like that. Maybe we'll just paint on 100% here again, so we'll get like a more of a... See if we can do something fun here. Because this allows us... So this should probably... Maybe we'll just paint a bit back on again. Then here. Oh, sorry. Just like that. There you go. And then just remove. We'll just add. Just turn it up 100% again. And we'll just go down a bit there. Great thing is, we can always go back and refine it. Nothing is final here. Like that. How's that look? So we'll just hide this totally here. And just maybe get this a bit more. Maybe even. Seems as if the eye is protruding a bit. Let's zoom out and see how that looks. Yeah. Something like that. And then, maybe we want the top part of the surface here to be a little bit transparent. So we'll just enhance the size. Click X. This is going to paint the pufferfish back on and go down to 10%. That it seems that right up here in the very top, you can see through just a little bit. How's that look? Yeah? Let's see how that looks. Yeah, something like that. And then in the bottom, we're going to select a bigger brush. Click X because now we're going to hide the bottom part just a little bit. Like with the 20%. Because the visibility down here is not as good as top. This is further behind. See how that looks? Yeah. And there you see, there you go. You can really paint. You can hide and you can paint it back on again. Let's say that we think this part here should be a, we should see more of the pufferfish. Just click your white color. Show a bit more. And also here, I think. We should zoom in a bit. And the whole thing is done by selecting different sizes with your brush, and the different opacities. And now, I guess we'll just, maybe we should just, this is too dark down here. Can't see enough of our wonderful pufferfish, so maybe. Just paint it back on again. And there you have it. And if you're making water, you could just, I'm just going to do this quickly, just add a bit of splashes so you can see that. I think actually this is going to work fine. Yeah. So now it seems as if our little friend is underwater. And this bottle here was also made transparent with layer masks. This is what the original bottle looks like. And I simply just painted on the bottle with a layer mask and added some lighting. Oh, and just one little thing. I just wanted to show you. Let's say that you've got a... We'll just hide our pufferfish here. And we'll just go to our dragon here, friend. And let's say you have, like, something in that's backlit. So we'll just add a sun. Just do that very quickly. Like that. Very quickly, sun. That. Just make it a bit. I'll just very quickly like that. And we'll just have a lens flare. There we go. There we go. There we go. Lens flare. And we'll just screen that. So now we've got a lens flare. We've got that here. And we'll just go to our dragon, select the dragon layer. Dragon layer. Sounds cool. And we'll just... Yeah, maybe that was a bit too much. Just add a bit again. No worries. There you go. Yeah. And that... is the awesome power of layers. You can use them to paint on, and you can use them to hide parts. And as always, as most things, the more time you spend on it, the better it becomes. Thank you very much for watching. Take care and be well.